the workers of this motherland. Sometimes they just call you journalists, they forget to reflect that you are also workers. So we know you as such, as workers, and we'd like to thank you very much for coming at a very, very short notice. We would like to apologize, however, to you. So we communicated the time to be 4 o'clock sharp, and then you were here on time. This is the time we are starting. Please, apology. It's not something that should continue like that. We are, as the National Union of Namibian Workers, going to communicate what we invited you for. Speaking is Petrus Tumajeni-Nagunda, the General Secretary of NUNW. Of course, from my left, we have Comrade Matthew from NUNW, Comrade Angola, Secretary General of NUNW, Comrade John Quedi, the General Secretary of NATAU, Comrade Munyaro is going to inform you what he intended to inform you, and his deputy, Comrade Tame, Comrade Penda, is the General Secretary of NAFAO. Here where we are, this is NAFAO office, as well as Comrade Thomas Gideon, the Head of Operation, and the support services from the Secretariat of the National Union of Namibian Workers. I want, therefore, to give this opportunity to Comrade Munyaro to communicate to you the objective of this press. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you, comrades. I hope it was necessary for us to call you again back to this hall in order to give you information that the public and the nation and the Namibian workers needs to hear. Today is about the removal of NUNW from SWAPO Party's Central Committee this morning. The media, members, the presidents of affiliate unions, secretary general and general secretaries, all affiliated unions to the mother body NUNW, our staff members present here, comrades and friends, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Central Executive Committee of the affiliated unions of NUNW, allow me to welcome you to this important press conference. The National Union of Namibian Workers was provoked by the malicious, deliberate, calculated, divisive action by Comrade Nangolo Mbumba, SWAPO Party Secretary General, at its special at its Central Committee today. At its special committee meeting held on the 19th of August 2017, the NUNW, as an autonomous and independent organization affiliated to the SWAPO Party, took decisions which were communicated to the SWAPO Party through the SWAPO Party Secretary General on the 28th of August in two separate letters, stating, number one letter having informed the SWAPO Party of the removal of Ismail Kasuto as its president, his removal and banning Kasuto from partaking at all structures of the bodies where he represented NUNW and his interest, and appoint Comrade Liswaniso as his acting president. Another letter followed on the same day, informed the SWAPO Party of the nomination of Comrade Petrus Tukonjeni-Nebonga to replace Comrade Kasuto in the SWAPO Party Central Committee as NUNW representative. Equally, on the 14th of September 2017, NUNW complied with the SWAPO party rules on nominations when it communicated its list of Congress delegates to SWAPO party, as requested by SWAPO party secretary general. Despite all this communication, to NUNW surprise and dismay, and for all reasons only known by the SWAPO party secretary general and probably few others, SWAPO party secretary general wrote a letter to Ismail Kasuto addressing him as president of NUNW, ignoring the fact that Ismail Kasuto was removed from the presidency of the Federation. Therefore, this places the credibility and ethics on governance of the officers of the SWAPO party secretary general and acting president to question. The officers of the acting president and the secretary general of the SWAPO party are under strict obligation to respect the decision taken by NUNW in terms of its constitution, the spirit of the accord, which governs the relationship between the Federation and the SWAPO party, as well as in compliance with SWAPO party constitution without fail or violation. NUNW, upon noting the failure by Secretary General and the acting president of SWAPO party, consciously or otherwise to abide by their obligation to respect its NUNW decisions, wrote a letter on the 5th of October to remind SWAPO party secretary general of its decision previously communicated to them. The NUNW was made to leave the proceedings of SWAPO party central committee, sending a mixed feeling message to the toiling workers that their fate during and under the term of the acting president of SWAPO party has been sealed to equal the era of colonial apartheid administration as administrator general of the then South African regime, which made the decision ultimately to impose it with impunity. The independence of NUNW as an autonomous and independent organization is now being placed on test after SWAPO party constitution and accord governing the relationship between the party and the Federation were dictatorial set aside. Thank you. The inclusive of NUNW from the exclusion and from of NUNW from SWAPO Party Central Committee, despite the office of SWAPO Party Secretary General having been duly notified of the legitimacy of this presentation to it, it is a clear message of the degree of intimidation meted out at members of SWAPO Party Central Committee and now extended to workers by acting president of the SWAPO party. NUNW takes the failure by the Secretary General to table communications by NUNW to the SWAPO party substantive constitutional structures that deals with matters related to the accord between SWAPO party and the Federation, NUNW, as a clear testimony to exclude workers from democratic processes. They are both the SWAPO party, Secretary General, and the acting SWAPO, acting president, whose considered decisions is tantamount to deliberate destruction of the SWAPO party. The perestroika style. This exclusion of NUNW from the SWAPO Party Central Committee provokes serious questions in the minds of all workers who are SWAPO members and delegate to SWAPO Party structures, and delegated to the SWAPO Party structures as representatives of NUNW in line with the accord and the SWAPO Party Constitution, including their representation to the upcoming SWAPO Party Congress. The central question that begs answers is whether the nullification of the accord in this highly negligent manner also by extension set aside workers' inherent rights to belong to associate to a freely and without fear of retrogressive reprimands, make inputs for others on matters affecting their livelihood. The decision by the top leadership of the SWAPO Party to deny NUNW its inherent rights in terms of the accord, which governs the relationship between the SWAPO Party, its constitution, and that has far-fetching consequences, since it is tantamount to redefining political constitutional rights of workers, thus begging for the clarifications by SWAPO Party. NUNW or workers, consequently is denied its right to participate in the democratic process of selecting candidates of their choice in the leadership of their own party. In conclusion, allow me to now inform the public that the correct official legitimate list of the NUNW delegates to the SWAPO Party Congress, as per the decision of the Central Committee, are as follows. From the women's side, Anna Shweda, Loite Shanika, Sarafina Kandere, Hilma Ushona, Louisa Deapo, Likali, Julia Njambi, Justina Jonas, Esther Anna Pondoka. From the main site is Jacob N. Fidaka, Comrade Yop Muniaro, Dr. Elia Gurare, John Ushona, Evans Mosou, Jesse Nombasa, Jacob Pender, Joseph Dinyando. NUNW delegates to SWAPO Party Central Committee, candidates to SWAPO Party Central Committee are as follows. Anna Shweda, Comrade Loite Shanika, Jacob Ifindaka, Comrade Job Muniaro. NUNW representatives to Central Committee, Petrus Tukonjeni Nabonga replaced Kasuto, has already replaced Kasuto in the Central Committee as per NUNW resolution and current post Congress. Having noted the Secretary General has misused his office to hide and withhold instructive correspondences by NUNW to the SWAPO party relevant structures. What's the consequence? Consequentially, having pretended in the Central Committee as if he did not receive, withheld, and hid NUNW crucial correspondences, and hide, supposed to, crucial correspondences. Having failed with malicious intent to communicate all crucial correspondences to any of NUNW to the political bureau, thus misled, misdirected the proceedings of both key structures with regard to the constitutional processes of nominating candidates, inclusive that of NUNW. Having noted that with appreciation, having noted with apprehension and utter disappointment, failure by the acting president of SWAPO Party to provide imperial and non-bias leadership, impartial and non-bias leadership to the SWAPO Party Secretary General, which resulted in NUNW being humiliated in favor of his malicious intent. NUNW demands that SWAPO Party Secretary General admits that he misled the SWAPO Party Central Committee and Politburo, and that he should apologize to the workers unconditionally within 3 days from today of this, from date of this statement. That NUNW list is as dictated by the Central Committee be accepted as submitted. That the nominated candidates to the SWAPO Party Central Committee, current and post Congress, be accepted unconditionally. Finally, this serves a call on the acting SWAPO President Comrade Akikengo that he has failed to provide leadership and direct Secretary General of SWAPO Party in line with the Constitution, in the accord between the Federation and SWAPO Party. Failure with which the NUNW will communicate to the party its final decision and consequences on this matter. Thank you.
Viva NUNW, viva!
Viva!
Viva NUNW, viva!
Viva!
Quite a fence. I think I think the media is also disappointed like us, but I think that is not in Namibian politics. We therefore, if you have some questions for this house to answer, we hope we can clarify some of your questions, of your concerns. We are a workers' organization. The SWAPO Party is ours. It does not belong to individuals. The SWAPO Party has constitutions that must be followed. Yes. We have rules. We have not bought our membership to the party. We are members through the constitution of the party. So what is going to happen is drastic steps in terms of the constitutions.
And how, what sort of impact will it have on your participation at the Congress?
No, we are not going to the Congress of the party by mercy. We belong to the party. We have our constitutional rights to attend this Congress. It's not that we are going to the Congress by mercy of somebody. It's constitutional. So we don't need to have any reason why we should go to Congress or not. I think this is high time that we need to communicate the way he did. We have sent official correspondences that we think it's going to be helpful and it's how leadership got to do correspondences. We have written to the Office of Secretary General. He has ignored, he had them. So for us, we see no way for us to send another letter to remind him. We will communicate this way to him. The consequences will also come this way.
But of course, if I may add, having been democratic all along, responsible all along, politically conscious all along of the past where we come from, and therefore everybody having noted the period of 27 years that has passed with less labor unrest in Namibia and no conflict of political nature, every conscious Namibian, every responsible Namibian ought to answer that question, not only the workers who are maliciously being placed on the spot. We hope those that have acted without thinking the practicality of this war will also provide a forum if it is necessary for us to engage. We have always been amenable, we have always been thoroughly thinking, and we have always been acting on this mandate that is given as leaders of equal standing to the public. The Federation is a national federation, is having the same status of any other national leadership. And therefore, upon communicating with our members, we shall take their directive, which they believe is fit to restore the previous relationship as was contained in the accord and in the constitution. We are talking about constitutional rights, not just labor rights. We are talking about Chapter 3, seriously put on the spot. And therefore, we hope there is finality. We do not see ourselves not participating at the Congress, because if anybody only saw the participation at the Central Committee, the delegation that comes from the region contains the same members. It's not just the participation of the Central Committee. Therefore, we are saying those that are thinking with anger at this time and misdirecting the process, we hope there is a positive outcome, and we hope we shall continue also learning from this that it's not the way to go.
Yeah, just an addition. You see, the office of the Secretary General of SWAPO Party is a higher office, is the office of the accounting officer of the SWAPO Party with the title of Secretary General. This is supposed to be an office headed by a person who conducts the administration of the SWAPO Party ethically and according to procedures, of course, in line with the SWAPO Party Constitution. If decisions are taken, especially in this case by the affiliated body, NUNW, communicated, and he failed intentionally to communicate it, it means that the position of this person in the office was a big mistake, and therefore it is equal to misplacement. Communication that letters instead, the letters that are communicated to the Secretary General of a decision taken by an affiliate organization supposed to be presented to the relevant body. He did not do that. He was also questioned in the Central Committee today to acknowledge or deny whether he has received those correspondences. He was mute. It means that he has malicious intent to do that. In addition, the fact that Mr. Kasuto was removed by the NUNW, his office chose to invite him for the reason only known by him. We term that as serious interference. The affiliation accord between SWAPO and NUNW, it recognizes that NUNW is an independent and autonomous, and it takes its decision unhindered. It is therefore a violation of that accord when we have taken a decision as NUNW, communicated to this office of the Secretary General and the Secretary General of the SWAPO party, find it right to tamper with it, hide it, and ignore. That render him being unethical and does not fit for that office.
Yes?
What do you think is the intent of this, of what is done? What is it? What do you think is he trying to do by this?
SWAPO party is a political party. It's not a political party of any individual. It is not there to fulfill the wish of an individual. It is there to fulfill collective wishes of the members. It has constitutions and rules. And all members of SWAPO are equal before SWAPO constitution. Equally, NUNW and its affiliates has constitutions that governs those organizations. Members of the unions are equal before the constitutions of their respective unions. We, as leaders of the NUNW, have got no mandate to discriminate our members. Our members have equal right. Also, the constitution of SWAPO has not given mandate to nor to the acting president, neither to the secretary general, to discriminate members of SWAPO who qualifies to contest positions. Now, decision to contest cannot let the person in charge, in this case the Secretary General, to behave and conduct himself unethical. He has got no qualification. Should he choose to do that, the best remedy is to have vacated the office yesterday already.
Okay, now, Ole, can you say that you, perhaps if you were...
That's not the issue here. No, that's not the issue here.
Sorry, the issue
here is the exclusion of
the
NUNW. We're not talking about nomination? No. We are talking about NUNW who have the right to participate in the Central Committee of NUNW, of SWAPO Party, in the Congress of SWAPO Party, but today, at the crucial Central Committee, where the members of the Central Committee of SWAPO, including NUNW, supposed to be there to deliberate on the issue of the party at hand. Now, this was not done, and that is what we are talking about.
So, we should not dwell much on issue of grade. You see, our exclusion today can tell you, the question is very relevant. We would have asked them in the meeting, because in our absence, while we were fired, in the absence of NUNW, Gurari was nominated, as you are rightly saying. So the importance is not, it's not us as a federation. The importance is him as a credible leader, because he was nominated in our absence. So it's a relevant question, but to wrong people.
Maybe we should direct our mind to this one. You see, the continuation of any generation is only guaranteed by the younger generation. You will never continue a generation with a generation that reaches its termination of age. Now, that, if one wants to put it on the spotlight as affecting all other young people, it's just telling you how blind we are to the continuation of the proper and succession of the leadership from one generation to another, which takes into consideration the age aspect. This is a proper way of destroying the party, not what is being presumed by preventing people from participating and testing the mind of those having the mandate to take them or not take them. I wonder, just to underline that this in the province of my tribe is equal to feathering the crow. You don't make it a bad thing.